everyone, and welcome to the show. My name is Sophie O'Connell.
I am Ji Lusan, and we are the directors of the Lemonades cast. We named our four casts after Girl Scout cookies, inspired by the famous Girl Scout scene in the Addams Family.
Our cast has been working tirelessly for the past 2 months to bring this show to life, and we truly hope that you enjoy the show as much as we've enjoyed working with such talented and hardworking actors.
Feel free to comment your appreciation for the show when we open the chat at the end of the performance. The recording of the performance will be available after the live showing if you would like to save it and rewatch it or send it to any friends and relatives who couldn't make it to the live show.
You can also find more information about the show and about Spotlight Theater in the playbill linked below, as well as on our website, including information on how to contact us and sign up for our upcoming summer shows.
One last announcement we want to make is that Spotlight Theater is transitioning to in-person programming in August this summer, as well as a virtual program.
If you have the means, please consider donating to the program through the fund linked in the chat. Donations will be held through the Brookline FOPA, Friends of Performing Arts, and will be going towards our props, costumes, set fund. We love what we do, and we so greatly appreciate any donations to help us make Spotlight Theater a permanent part of the Brookline community.
And now, without further ado, please enjoy The Addams Family.
My, my, my. What do we have here? Funny of you to assume that we would just let you into our lovely home. I would like to point out that things were looking quite peaceful today before you came along. Oh, very well, then. But I'll be watching you. Not a single word from you, but I can sense your fear. Who am I? You may ask. Why? You're about to find out.
Come, sorrow. We welcome you. Let us join in grief and honor the fortunate dead.
Wednesday, can I stop digging now?
Quiet, Pugsley. Don't you hear that? With every hour comes a certain phase of the moon. Right, Grandmama? It looks as though the grave is big enough for the ceremony to begin. Pugsley, grab the cat and make sure to put it into the box.
I put it in the box. What do I do now?
Isn't it obvious? You bury it.
Isn't it just lovely to see the children playing outside?
Oh, Gomez, they're growing up way too fast. I remember like it was just yesterday, Wednesday, chasing Pugsley around, that chainsaw we got her for her third birthday.
Oh, they had so much fun with that. I believe it was the same day we attached Pugsley's head back on for the first time.
That was the proudest I've ever felt.
And now that we're expecting another, the rest of our days will be filled with nothing but endless joy at heart.
Oh, Gomez, can you believe it? In just 3 days' time, we'll be welcoming the newest member of our family to the small, precious world.
Brother! Brother!
Oh, dear. Gomez, remember when he said the baby was coming in 3 days?
Of course.
Change of plans.
Got you. Getting to Ambassador, are we? What's the baby's name? What's going to occur and what happened to the cat? Well, wouldn't you like to know?
Thing, why don't you do everyone a favor and step aside?
When can we see the baby? I heard that babies are a special kind of breed. Almost too human.
Well, I sure hope they're doing all right in there.
Father?
What's the news?
Brother?
What is it?
It's an Addams! Welcome home, my son.
You know, when you have a new baby, one of the other children has to die.
Not true.
Everyone knows it is.
Then which one of us will have to go?
Well, they only need one boy.
Morticia? What is his name?
Well, once it's picked a name that was quite special and endearing, marking a phase in life that we all must go through. We named him something.
Right there. Oh, Boo-hoo, did I ruin your moment? I warned you. I told you to watch your back.
Dang. Little lovely surprise. You know, Morticia here was just announced to tell everybody the baby's name.
Oh, well then. Dearest Morticia, carry on.
As I was saying, we wanted to pick a name that was memorable. Something quite peculiar.
We named him Pubert.
Pugsley, the baby weighs 10 pounds and the cannonball weighs 20 pounds. Which will hit the stone walkway first?
I'm still on fractions.
Which do you think?
The cannonball.
Which one will bounce?
The baby?
Well, there's only one way to find out.
Ready?
3, 2, 1.
What a glorious evening.
The children are awfully quiet tonight.
Hey, why'd you catch him?
Children, do you hate the baby?
We don't hate him. We just wanted to play with him.
Especially his head.
You think we love the baby more than we love you?
Oh, yes, definitely.
Oh, sibling rivalry. Gomez, do you remember what we were like? I hated you.
I despised you.
I tied him to a tree.
I tried to mail him to a place that doesn't even exist. Old times.
Children, you see?
Rose Dowd, Art 6. An invisible one that flies in the night, and the howling storm has a found a bed of crimson joy. In his dark secret life, does a life destroy?
Justice is served.
Bring forward the evil one. You have betrayed the people of France. How do you plead?
Guilty. He is guilty, all right.
Well then, by admission, the sentence will have to be death.
Children, what are you doing?
My darling, I'm worried about you. All this stress, all this squabbling.
I'll be fine. I'm just trying to have it all. A loving husband, a family.
I just wish we had more time.
To seek out the dark forces?
Oh, to sleep. Oh, how I have missed the blessing of sleep.
You know, brother, there may just be one easy solution to your problem.
And what would that be?
Hiring a babysitter.
A babysitter. Are you sure?
Yes. A babysitter. B-A-B-Y-S-I-T-T-E-R. The person who looks after the children while the parents are gone.
That is a lovely idea.
We must start looking for babysitters right away.
But how do we know that we found the right one?
You'll just know. Trust me on this one.
Your eyes shield, your ears shield, your everything. Now, I know I'm constantly interrupting. There's no need to be peeved. My interjections are extremely important. On second thought, I think we might have started on the wrong foot. Hello, my name is Thing, and things are about to get a lot more complicated.
I know we're all concerned about the environment, so this morning, let's discuss how to prevent forest fires.
Prevent them?
Why, yes. It is always important to keep the environment healthy. We don't want throwing more trash into the ocean.
Lady, what do you suppose we do?
Well, let's start by taking out the trash at home.
What's your name again?
Heather.
Well then, Heather, why don't you follow us out the door?
Of course. I would love to help in any way that I possibly can.
How's that for taking out the trash?
Children.
All right, children, it's time for chores. You, girl, go wash the dishes.
Thing already licked them clean.
And the lawn is a disgrace. It must be cut immediately.
Yeah, but I don't want to wake up Schrodinger.
Who?
The cat.
Children, I have had it up to here. Now you just answer one simple question. Where is that baby?
We're still looking for the second half of it.
Children!
I would run if I were you, or you'll be next. Another one?
Not again. This person's a puppet.
Hello, kitties. I'm Polly the puppet.
Hello, Polly.
What should we do today?
Find some tasty puppet-flavored food for Thing?
Oh, I know. Let's go to the park.
I'll go to the park with you, but only in exchange for your mortal soul.
Ogamez, what are we to do?
The children have driven away every possible babysitter.
I know. I suppose we'll just have to.
Is this the Adams residence?
Why, yes.
Well, hello. I'm Debbie Tulinski from the Ages.
Ugh, another one.
The agency? They claimed no one else was available.
Well, surprise. I've been out of town for a while. Are you the mom?
Yes, I'm Mrs. Adams.
I love your dress.
Thank you. Gomez, I believe you may have found a new nanny. Miss Jelinski.
Oh, please, call me Debbie.
Hello again. Doesn't this suit me nicely? See what I did there? All right. I'll get back to the rest of the story. I'll just be here waiting. In fact, we are very similar. You and I are always...
Thing. Leave.
Well, hello there, children. Oh, Morticia, I can show you all my references so you know I'm not a homicidal maniac.
Of course you're not. You're too young.
Oh, Debbie, there's a bell prize and a dungeon down below.
Cable? Oh, and where's the babe?
He's right here.
He's adorable. He's perfect. What's his name?
Oh, it was Agony. He went through all the usual baby names. Lucifer, Burp, Banana. Then we finally came to our senses. Something a child could live with. Hubert.
Hubert. I like it. Oh, I just adore little babies. Hello, Hubert. I love you.
Children, don't just stand there. What do we say?
Be afraid. Be very afraid.
Look at you both, all cooped up in this house with a new baby. That's not easy, is it? Why, I guess sometimes you wish it's still just the two of you. You have a wonderful family, although there's one person I haven't met yet. Hi there, mister.
Mister, come on out here.
Say hi to Debbie.
Hello, Debbie. I am here. Your like it looks very light.
You're too kind.
All of this is nice, but when does Debbie start babysitting?
In a month? In a year?
Why not tonight?
Fantastic. Well, in that case, Thing, why don't you show Debbie around?
Well, of course. Good night, Scream, if you need anything.
Good night. Oh, now let's see.
Tonight on America's Unsolved Crimes, we investigate the case of the so-called Black Widow. She mates and she kills. She goes after the richest and the loneliest bachelors and gains their trust and love. Then on the wedding night, she kills them. The deaths appear accidental, but after the funeral, she disappears with cash in hand. Soon after, the Black Widow strikes again, a mistress of disguise. She has eluded the authorities for years. Who is she, and who is her next victim? All we can say is, bachelors, beware.
We'll be going out for most of the morning.
Here are all the important numbers. Police, fire department, morgue.
Goodbye, Fester.
Say goodbye to Debbie.
Bye, Debbie. You look really pretty today. Not like you don't look really pretty every day.
Have fun! Treasury bill stocks. Toothbrush. What a strange old house. This is really no place for children. Oh no, don't cry. Shut up, you little brat.
He's not a brat.
Of course not. He's an adorable little baby. I was getting him ready for a nice stroll around the park.
Are you really a babysitter?
Well, that is quite the question.
Why did you come here?
To take care of you all.
Especially my uncle.
Funny. Just so funny. I've been meaning to talk to you.
Is something wrong?
You see, the children have been dying to ask you. They've been talking about it all morning. They're just afraid that you think that they don't love you. They have their hearts set on it. I knew you'd want to know as concerned parents, of course.
What should we do?
How could we say no?
I'm sure they deny everything, but they truly want to go.
To that wretched place, you know, long ago, some ancient spirit whispered in my ear and told me there was going to be a bound of horrors where no one ever comes out alive.
Yes, Debbie, are you sure?
I'm positive, and after all, they've been talking about it all day.
Tired of your kids bothering you 24/7?
So, Camp Buckler is the place for you to take your child.
We're able to ensure your child's safety most of the time.
From lemonade stands to Girl Scout cookies to swimming with alligators, we have everything.
Activities include testing water slides made by last year's campers.
We even have annual plays.
Written by yours truly.
Ah! Becky, Gary, my lip gloss was just ruined.
Oh, and a camper was just fell off the water slide, and a Girl Scout was just
being hit by a... Shh. Go play on the incredibly fun playground. The playground was made by your counselors and is mostly sturdy. Isn't that right, Amanda?
So come join Camp Buckler.
Where fun meets more fun!
Paul's not killing him right now! Wait! I'm alive!
summer camp.
What was that terrible sound? Troy? Laughter.
It's certainly quite peculiar.
Something extraordinary, special, something right out of those horror stories that your father used to read to both of you before.
Fresh air, the smell of pine.
Wednesday, look at all of those other children.
Their freckles, their bright little eyes, their friendly smiles help them.
Hi, I'm Amanda Buckman.
Hello!
Why are you all dressed up going to a funeral?
Hello there, I'm Don Buckman. This is my wife, Grace. Isn't this place just something else?
Certainly is.
You know, a kid has to be very special to get into this camp.
Our man has already skipped 2 grades.
What about this boy?
Oh, probation.
Well, Amanda just couldn't wait for camp to start.
It's all she talked about. She even got a new whole wardrobe. What about this little lady?
Wendy's at that very special age where a girl has only one thing on her mind.
Boys?
Homicide.
Hello, everybody.
And welcome to Camp Buckler.
I'm Gary Granger.
I'm Becky Martin Granger.
We are the owners and directors here.
Obviously, we're here to learn, to grow, and to just have fun.
Yes, that's our cue to leave. Goodbye, children. And remember to just have fun.
We're going to miss you, like crazy.
You have everything, your favorite snack, your glitter heels, and your peppermint chapstick.
Don't forget the cherry.
Of course the cherry, we'll miss you so much.
Don't worry, if we forgot something, I'll just have the camp call you and you can drive right back here with it. Bye-bye.
I don't think I like it here.
Joelle, stand up straight, please.
Mom, you're embarrassing me.
Don't start with me, Joelle. Stand up straight. Stand up straight.
Wednesday. Is everything okay?
I'm just worried about Fester. We need to find somewhere to get out of here.
I better not hear from that camp leaving causing any trouble. Do you hear me, young lady?
Yes, ma'am.
Have fun at camp, Joelle, and stand up straight.
Hey, Wednesday, the girls at the Grizzly Cabin are going to be having a party tonight. We'll be painting your nails and everything. Do you want to come?
Hard pass.
Welcome to Jerome's, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Bill Johnson, and I'll be your entertainment for tonight. So settle in and get ready for a lovely night of music and laughter.
Thank you so much again for inviting me to Title Up and Night Out. It really makes me feel like part of the family.
No, Debbie, thank you. I never would have known that the children wanted to go to that summer camp without you. You have such a way with them. Oh, and I do hope Grandmama is managing all right with Pubert back home.
Thank you, Miss Adams. You're too much. Don't worry, I'm sure they're having a grand time. Let's get your mind off of it. I'm going into the Bill Johnson guy to suggest a song. You want to come choose with me?
I'd be delighted.
Wow, what a place. Look at all those people dancing with each other in love.
So we've hired Miss Jelinski. She's just perfect, don't you think?
Yep, she's perfect.
Oh, Fester, I'm such a lucky man. I hope that one day you too will know the indescribable joy of having children and then paying someone else to raise them.
You know,
Wouldn't I have to get married first?
Oh, there's plenty of time for that. But you will meet someone. Someone very special. Someone who won't press charges.
You know, all these years I've seen you and Morticia waltzing around the hallways, I've been so happy for you. But I must confess I've been jealous. I've always dreamed that there might be someone for me too.
Well, there's Thing.
But I want more than, should I maybe ask Debbie to dance? What if she says no?
But what if she says yes?
Would you come dance too? You, Morticia?
Why, of course.
And now we ask everyone to gather on the dance floor as we play a suggestion from two of the lovely ladies here with us tonight.
How's it going over here?
Oh, it's a little lemonade stand.
I knew that you two were the right choice for Ken Butler's kindness project.
How many cups have you sold so far?
Do you think we're counting?
Well, we're gonna let you kids get back to it then.
Hello, is this lemonade made from real lemon?
Yes.
I only like all natural fruits and beverages. Are you sure they're real lemons?
Yes.
I'll tell you what, I'm only 12 boxes away from getting my Marketing Your Dream Cookie CEO badge. I'll buy a cup of your lemonade if you buy a box of my delicious Girl Scout cookies. Do we have a deal?
Are they made of real Girl Scouts?
The nerve.
All right, campers, gather around. To start off, let's give a big thank you to Wednesday and Pugsley for managing the lemonade stand this morning.
Woohoo!
And for our activity of the day, I have a very important announcement for you all. It's a Ken Buckler traditional for Becky and me to choose some very special campers to act in our yearly theatrical productions.
Oh, I love the Camp Buckler productions, especially since Gary is such a talented playwright.
Oh, you're too kind. I bet you're all wondering what this year's production will be.
We're all just dying to find out.
Let's be kind now. Gary, go on. What's this year's production?
This year, Ken Buckler will be producing a play that's very close to my heart. Call it The Beauty and the Beast.
My parents always tell me what a fantastic actress I am. You know, maybe I'll even be on TV someday. Well, I really want to be Belle. I deserve to be Belle. Dancing around a flowy yellow ball gown. Wouldn't that just be amazing?
Too many bugs. There are too many bugs at this camp.
Well, are you even listening to me?
Shoo, you fly.
Amanda, she's talking about you.
Ugh, thanks, although there really are too many bugs at this camp.
Maybe Wednesday and I can help you with that. We're planning to sneak out of here anyways.
Why?
because of this.
Our uncle's getting married.
That's great. Congratulations.
No, he's getting married to a psychopath. He just doesn't know it yet.
Oh, not so great. So what's the plan?
Make our way to the back gate and through the forest, and then we'll wing it from there.
Sounds like a solid plan. I'm in.
Good. We leave tonight.
Please, everybody take your seats to prepare for the truly beautiful milestone in this couple's life.
That Gabby Galinsky,
Mr. Adams, be your husband, be your couple, love, happiness,
and all of it.
And you, Fester Adams, Gabby Galinsky as your wife.
I do.
Then you may kill the bride, honestly.
What is it? What a beautiful ceremony, don't you think? If only the children could have been here to see. You know, I remember the first day that I met Fester. It was raining. The thunder was crashing and the lightning was violent. As the sun, Fester was walking.
Kids are at summer camp singing songs by the campfire and laughing.
Well then, seems like somebody needs a little rest. Let's carry on home.
Isn't this right?
Are you ready to go back home now, Debbie?
Oh, yes, but we can't go back to your house. See, we're married now. We need a place of our own.
But,
dear, I picked a lovely house with a lovely ocean view as well.
I do love the ocean.
Great. I'm Mother, what a surprise. Yes, his name's Fester. Lots of money. It'd be a shame once he's gone. Mother, I can't tell you that. All I can say is that by tonight, after the funeral, I'll have the money in hand. And no, Mother, I won't share it with you. Thank you so much. Goodbye now.
What was that?
Just a friend of mine congratulating us on our marriage.
That's awesome. Oh, Gomez and Morticia were thinking of coming over later to have a nice dinner.
Fester?
Yes, my love?
You can't see your family anymore.
Wait, why not?
Well, you do love me, don't you?
Well, yeah.
If you truly love me, then you do as I ask. And I'm asking you to never come in contact with another Adams again.
So I can't see my family ever again?
See, you get it. Oh, you're so very smart. You look exhausted. Why don't you go take a shower?
I guess I'll just have to write them a letter.
Write who a letter?
Gomez and Morticia, of course.
Fester did hear what I said.
Yes, I'm going.
One, plug in the radio to the outlet. Step two, play some terrible country music. Step three, distraction. Sounds easy enough. Fester, I brought you some music. Oh no, what a terrible accident.
Wow, Debbie, this is really great music. Honey, is everything all right?
Everything's just fantastic.
Get up and go. Get up and go.
This way.
Get up and go back.
We're right behind you.
Hurry up.
Wednesday, Bachelor Joella.
They're right over there.
Oh, look, they found us.
Told you some sneak out.
Amanda, are those night vision goggles?
I didn't even know those came in pink.
Everybody calm down. Now, were you planning on running away?
Yes.
And why is that?
I have some family matters to attend to.
And are family matters really more important than some summer fun?
More important than making new friends?
I think you should be punished. Punished.
I'm sensing some tension here. I was just about to announce a casting for the play.
What?
Yeah. In the middle of the night, so realistic.
Gary, let's let the children get to sleep. It's pretty late.
Almost we're staking out.
Don't worry, we'll think of something.
I want to ask, this isn't only about your uncle getting married, is it?
Do you believe in the existence of evil?
Have you met my mother?
We need to put a stop to this.
But how?
For once, I really don't know.
What is it?
It's a letter.
Is it from Bester?
I think so.
Move out of the way. I'll read the letter and all those points.
I'll read it out loud. Dear brother, I wish you were here and I can never see you again. From Fester. P.S. Debbie says hi. I don't understand.
For weeks we haven't heard anything from him, and now this.
Have I done something? Why does my brother despise me?
He doesn't. He adores you.
I'd do anything for him. I'd die for him.
We know.
Has he gone mad?
This is just some post-honey phrase.
Morticia, do you still love me after all these years?
Of course. Just give Fester some time. I'm sure he'll come around.
Oh my!
What is it? First my brother, now my son. What to do? Sing!
Yes?
You know what to do.
Oh, yeah. Operation thing in action. You should have asked sooner. You know, I'm really good at top secret operations. I'll sneak into Debbie's house and no problem and find out what they're up to. Wait, where did everybody go? Why do you guys always do this to me?
And for our lead to play the role of Bella, we have selected the wonderful Amanda Bachman.
I wasn't expecting this at all. This is so exciting.
Joelle, you will be playing the Beast. Pugsley, we've chosen you for Gaston. And Wednesday, you will be Lumiere.
What?
The famous candlestick. Haven't you ever watched Beauty and the Beast as a little girl?
No.
Very well, then let's get to practicing.
Guest, be our guest, put our service to the test.
Roar! Beast, why are you like this?
Grr, because no one ever loved me. Wolf!
You're really gonna keep me here. Can't I go back to my father?
No, meow.
No one's quick as Gaston.
Oh no, it's Gaston.
Let me break it to you, Belle. You got kidnapped by a monster and no one in your town cared enough to come save you.
off script. Oh, really, Lumiere?
Yes, and the only two people who love you are the Beast and the town idiot.
That's a funny joke, Lumiere.
Who said it was a joke?
Stop, you're running a performance.
You three, get out!
I was just getting you a present. But don't open it yet. I'm gonna go head out for a little bit, and you can open it when I'm gone.
But won't that ruin the surprise?
No, it won't ruin the surprise. It'll be better for you to open it when I'm not here.
But
goodbye. He's gone. The bomb came out of nowhere.
Debbie, are you okay?
I want you dead. I want your money.
But don't you love me?
This was never about loving me.
Oh, Morticia. I feel as though I'm dying without my brother.
I know, my love, but he's happy now. This is what we wanted, Professor. Is it not?
Ugh.
What can I do, darling? I can't have a human son and a dead husband.
Fester? Oh, Fester!
Huxley?
Wednesday?
Debbie?
Wednesday? What's going on here?
Debbie!
We finally got out of that camp.
Debbie is
a crazy person, excuse me, you little rat! A child, I wanted one thing and one thing only. A ballerina Barbie and a pretty pink tutu. You know what I got? I got a stupid Ken doll. That's not what I wanted, and it's not who I was, and ever since then I despise them. All of them, and in my rage, I burned my house down. When I grew up, all I wanted was a nice rich husband. You know what I got?
Not a nice rich husband.
I got Fester. Anyways.
She goes on to describe her plan. Let's skip ahead.
And there's nothing you can do to stop me. And now I shall electrocute you all.
Morticia, I just want to say.
Shut up. This is why I hate men.
Oh. She got electrocuted.
Oh no.
We're free.
Joelle? You saved us!
I did?
Yes, you did, you idiot. She was just about to kill us. Thank you.
Oh, Fester, I'm so sorry about everything. Who knew a local babysitter could be a serial killer?
No, I'm sorry. She forced me to stay away from y'all.
Oh, brother!
Brother!
Will you take a moment to acknowledge the person who saved our lives?
Everyone, this is Joelle, my friend.
Hi!
Hi, I'm Finn. Yeah. I see you've made it through the show. Congrats. I'll give you a rundown of how everything went down. Morticia and Gomez are still happy as ever. Grandma Emma is still, in fact, alive. Bet you weren't expecting that. Peeber is becoming less human as the day, and his parents are so proud. Wednesday and Joelle are now besties of friends and get up to all sorts of trouble with Pugsley. Fester is, well, still lonely, but I heard there's a new babysitter in town. I guess we have to wait to see what happens next with the Addams family.
Oh, caught in a bad romance. I want your ugly, I want your disease.